Welcome back to White Paper and Chill. In this episode, we're breaking down a really fascinating new development in blockchain tech. It's from a white paper called Moonshot, Optimistic Proposal for Blockchain-Based State Machine Replication. Quite a mouthful.
It definitely is, but the core idea is pretty exciting.
So here's what we'll cover. First, we'll get into the basic problem, you know, how these networks all agree on stuff, quickly.
A consensus challenge.
Then we'll unpack Moonshot's optimistic proposal. That's their big idea for speeding things up.
The core innovation, really.
We'll also look at how it actually performed in tests, you know, compared to what's already out there.
Real world numbers. Always good to see.
And finally, we'll talk about what this might mean for you, the end user, for developers, and just the whole crypto space.
Sounds good. Yeah.
Sounds great. Let's jump in.
Okay, so setting the scene. Public blockchains are really changing things, right? Decentralized systems, verifiable data.
Absolutely. They offer a new model for trust and exchange.
But underneath it all, there's this fundamental challenge. How do all these different computers, these participants, agree on the exact order of transactions? That's state machine replication, SMR.
Yeah, SMR. In simple terms, it's just about making sure every computer keeps the same record, or the same history, in the same order, like everyone having the identical copy of a shared ledger.
And it has to be consistent, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Consistent and agreed upon. And crucially, for these decentralized networks, the protocol needs to be Byzantine Fault Tolerant, BFT.
Okay, BFT, that sounds important.
It is. It basically means the system can keep working correctly, keep everyone in agreement, even if some participants up to a certain limit are offline, malfunctioning, or even, you know, actively malicious,
yeah,
trying to cheat the system.
That tolerance for bad actors is key for trust, I imagine.
It's fundamental. Without BFT, the whole idea of a trustless system falls apart.
Right. So this white paper introduces Moonshot. It's described as a new family of these BFT blockchain-based SMR protocols, and its defining feature, the big innovation, is this optimistic proposal.
That's the core concept.
It sounds, well, optimistic. Almost too simple. What's the catch? Or maybe, what's the real conceptual shift beyond just speed?
That's a great way to put it. It is a conceptual shift. Think of optimistic proposal as like a calculated risk, a smart shortcut.
Okay.
Instead of rigidly waiting for absolute confirmation that step A is finished and verified before even starting step B.
Which sounds slow.
It can be. So instead, you make an educated guess. You optimistically assume step A will be confirmed, and you go ahead and start proposing step B based on that assumption.
Ah, I see. But what if the assumption is wrong?
That's the crucial part. There's a built-in safety net, a fallback path, as the paper calls it. If step A doesn't get confirmed as expected, the system has a way to backtrack and correct itself without breaking or losing consistency.
So the optimism is balanced with a recovery plan.
Precisely. It changes trust from always wait for certainty to assume things work, but have a robust way to fix it if they don't, which in practice, failures are rare.
Okay, that makes sense. So connecting this back, why should you, listening at home, care about these deep protocol details?
Well, it boils down to user experience.
Right, because more efficient agreement, faster consensus, that means faster transactions for you.
Exactly. Lower waiting times, potentially lower fees, because the network can handle more traffic.
And just a smoother feel for decentralized apps, whether it's DeFi, games, whatever, making it feel less clunky, more like the web apps we use every day.
That's the goal. Seamless performance.
All right, let's dig deeper into this optimistic proposal then. The paper calls it advanced round pipelining. Can you maybe unpack that a bit? Pipelining, assembly lines.
Yeah, the assembly line analogy is pretty good. In computing, pipelining means overlapping stages of a task. So while one part is finishing, the next part is already starting.
Speeds things up.
Right. Moonshot pushes this further. Normally in blockchain consensus, you have stages like propose a block, prepare the block, vote on the block.
Mm-hmm.
With basic pipelining, maybe you start preparing block two while block one is being voted on. With Moonshot's optimistic approach, the leader can actually propose block two, even if block one isn't fully confirmed or certified yet.
Based on that optimistic assumption we talked about.
Exactly. Assuming block one will be fine.
And the specific version, Chained Moonshot, uses two main techniques for this.
Correct. First is that optimistic proposal itself. Leaders propose optimistically. This helps use network bandwidth better, less waiting around.
Okay. And the second?
The second is vote broadcasting. Instead of sending votes to, say, one leader or aggregator who then bundles them up.
Which could be a bottleneck.
Potentially, yes. In Chain Moonshot, validators just broadcast their votes out to everyone directly. This keeps validators busy and helps information spread quickly. It avoids that central collection point slowing things down.
Makes sense. Distribute the load. Now, this is where it gets really compelling, right? The numbers. The white paper compares chained Moonshot to Tendermint and Jolteon.
Yeah, Tendermint is a well-known BFT protocol, and Jolteon is a variant of chained hot stuff, another modern protocol. So good benchmarks.
And the results. Let's talk latency first. Block finalization latency.
Okay, so latency is how long it takes for a block to be considered final, irreversible. They measure it in units of delta, which is basically one average network message delay.
One hop across the network, roughly?
Sort of, yeah. Chained Moonshot aims for a best-case finality in three.
Three network delays. How does that compare?
Jolteon is typically five. Tendermint is also around three in its best case for finality, though its block proposal rate is different. So compared to Jolteon, that's potentially a 40% lower latency. Faster finality.
40% faster finality than Jolteon. That's significant. What about how often new blocks are made? The block period.
That's even more dramatic. Jolteon Moonshot aims for a best case block period of just one network delay. Compare that to Jolteon's two or Tendermint's three. So that's potentially a 50% decrease in the block period compared to Jolteon. Blocks get proposed twice as fast.
So just to recap for everyone listening, lower delta means faster. Three finality is faster than five. And a one-block period is much faster than two or three.
Exactly. Fewer network round trips needed to get things done.
So what does that 40% lower latency, 50% faster block period feel like for you as a user?
It means less staring at a pending transaction screen.
Right. Things just confirm quicker. Interactions with dApps feel more immediate, more responsive. Especially important if the network is busy.
Definitely. It tackles that frustrating lag head on.
But back to that potential issue, the optimism. What if a leader does propose block two based on block one, but then block one fails certification? Doesn't the chain break?
That's where the fallback path comes in, the safety net. The white paper explains that if an optimistic proposal turns out to be based on an uncertified parent, the leader can issue a special fallback recovery proposal.
Okay, a recovery mechanism.
Yeah, this proposal is not optimistic. It's fully justified based on the actual confirmed state of the network. It basically gets things back on track. This ensures safety, meaning the ledger remains consistent. No forks or anything like that.
Does triggering that fallback slow things down significantly? Is there a big overhead cost to this safety net?
That's a fair concern. The design aims to make the fallback efficient. It does introduce a bit more complexity, logically. But the white paper suggests, and the experiments seem to confirm, that these fallbacks are expected to be rare enough in practice that the overhead is negligible compared to the average speed up you get from optimism.
So the gamble usually pays off, and when it doesn't, the cost to fix it isn't crippling.
That seems to be the idea, yes. The net gain is substantial.
And they actually built and tested this. It's not just theory.
Right. They implemented chained Moonshot, often by modifying existing code for Jolteon, which makes comparison easier, and they ran experiments on AWS EC2 instances.
Simulating a real wide area network, like the internet.
Exactly. They tested it with different network sizes, 10 nodes, 50, 100, up to 200 nodes, and different amounts of data in each transaction, the payload size.
And the results from these experiments, did they match the theory?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Chain Moonshot consistently outperformed Jolteon in all their tests.
Consistently?
Yes. On average, across all configurations, they saw about 41.1% lower block commit latency. So blocks got confirmed significantly faster.
Wow. Over 40% faster confirmation on average.
And maybe even more importantly for capacity, they saw 54.9% higher block throughput, meaning the network could process way more transactions per second.
Almost 55% more transactions. That's huge for scalability.
It really is. And they noted that in some specific setups, the latency decrease was even better, up to nearly 59%.
So the real world tests back up those impressive theoretical numbers.
They do. It suggests that even with the extra communication from broadcasting votes, the overall performance gain in realistic scenarios is significant, and the overhead is manageable.
Okay, so for you, the listener, this isn't just academic theory. It's tested. Practical improvement. It's about making blockchains actually work better at scale.
Mm-hmm. And there are a couple of other interesting design points worth mentioning.
Go on.
One is asynchronous agreement. Moonshot allows participants to join the consensus process without needing the entire massive history of the blockchain downloaded first.
Ah, that sounds useful.
It is, especially for systems where validators might join or leave frequently. It also helps decouple the ordering of transactions from their delivery and execution, which can make system design more flexible for developers.
More modular, maybe?
Yeah, you can think of it that way. More flexible architecture.
Okay, what else?
The other is an externally verifiable blockchain. This uses something called a commit certificate.
A certificate, like proof.
Exactly. It's a cryptographic proof attached to a block that shows it's been finalized by the required number of validators. The cool thing is, anyone, even someone not running a validator node, can take this certificate and verify the block's legitimacy.
So it improves transparency, auditability.
Both. Makes it easier for light clients, auditors, or just regular users to confirm the state of the chain without needing massive resources.
Okay, great. So let's zoom out now. We've covered the tech, the performance. Let's hit those big impact questions. First off, do we need this? Are current solutions not good enough?
I'd say yes, we absolutely need this kind of innovation. While current solutions work, they often struggle with the scalability and speed needed for truly mainstream applications. Think mass adoption. We need faster, more efficient foundations.
Right. So how specifically does something like Moonshot improve crypto as a whole?
By tackling that foundational layer, the consensus mechanism, making it faster and handle more volume means the entire ecosystem built on top can be more powerful. It enabled applications that just weren't practical before because the underlying network was too slow or expensive.
Okay, drilling down now. How does this impact you, the end user, the retail community, consumers?
For you, it can mean noticeably faster transactions, less waiting. It could also mean lower transaction fees eventually because the network can handle more capacity, reducing congestion. Basically, a much smoother, less frustrating experience using crypto day to day.
Less friction, more like using, well, normal apps.
That's the aim. Reduce the blockchain-specific friction points.
What about the builders, the developers creating these applications? What's in it for them?
They get a better toolkit. A more efficient, robust, flexible engine to build on. They can design more ambitious applications without being immediately constrained by the underlying network speed or throughput limits. It unlocks creativity.
So it raises the ceiling for what's possible to build.
Exactly. Higher performance, more design flexibility.
And finally, the big picture. How does this impact crypto and blockchain overall? Where does it push the technology?
It pushes the entire field forward. It shows continuous improvement at the most fundamental level. Innovations like Moonshot contribute to the maturity of blockchain tech, making it more viable for real-world, large-scale use cases. It helps build credibility and drives toward wider adoption. Ultimately, the promise here, as laid out in the white paper, is a foundation for blockchain networks that are significantly faster, more efficient, and ready for the next wave of decentralized innovation.
Yeah, this white paper really does underscore that relentless innovation happening right at the heart of blockchain. It's not just about new coins or apps, but improving the core engine.
Mm-hmm, the infrastructure layer.
And solutions like Moonshot, tackling speed and efficiency head on with these, you know, clever, optimistic ideas, they really are paving the way for a future where dApps feel just as smooth, just as responsive as everything else we use online.
Hopefully getting us closer to that seamless future.
It definitely makes you wonder, though, what other optimistic shortcuts or maybe unexpected complexities are waiting to be discovered as we keep pushing these boundaries.
That's the exciting part, isn't it? Always more to explore.